Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. We have a very, very complex expression today. We have cosine I plus I times sine I. I is the complex unit, the square root of negative 1. We want to find the cosine of I and sine of I, and then we will evaluate this expression. Now my friends, let me remind you that e to the power of I x is equal to cosine x plus I times sine x. Using this and e to the power of negative I x, which is equal to again cosine x, since cosine is even but sine is odd, then that factors out the negative sign, minus I sine x, we can find, actually adding the two equation, we can find cosine x is equal to e to the power of I x plus e to the power of negative I x divided by 2. This is the complex expression of cosine function. Now we can find cos I. For x is equal to I, we have cos I is equal to e to the I, which is I squared, plus e to the negative I, which is negative I squared, divided by 2. So cos I is equal to, I squared is negative 1, e to the negative first power plus, this is 1, e to the first power divided by 2. Surprisingly, this is a real number. Similarly, we can find the sine I, which is, by subtracting the two equation, we can find sine x actually is equal to e to the ix minus e to the negative ix divided by 2i this time. And again, putting I for the x, we will find sine I is equal to e to the I squared, which is e to the negative first power, minus e to the negative I squared, which is e to the first power, divided by 2i. So remember, we want to find cos I plus I times sine I. Now we have found cos I is equal to e to the negative first power plus e divided by 2 plus this I times sine I is e to the negative first power minus e divided by 2i. You can see we can cancel this I here. Then we have a common denominator, so we can add the powers at the numerator, plus e and minus e cancels. We have 2 times e to the negative first power divided by 2. Then we have e to the negative first power, or just 1 over e. This is very nice, since we have found cos i plus i times sine I is equal to cos I plus I times sine I is equal to 1 over e. This very complex expression is now equal to a real number, 1 over e. Actually, let me show you a second method, which is very fast. Second way, again using the same reasoning, we have e to the power of ix is equal to cos x plus I sine x, and we want to find cos I plus I sine I. Then let x be I, we will have cos I plus I sine I is equal to e to the power of I times I, which is e to the power of I squared. Then I squared is negative 1 by definition, so e to the negative first power, or 1 over e. This is very fast. But I wanted to show you that sine x function and cosine x function are defined in complex numbers too. Thank you for watching and see you in the next videos.